What is the best example of just because you can, doesn't mean you should? Blindly trusting traffic laws as a pedestrian. Yes, if you get hit, it's the driver's fault. But all it takes is for one driver not paying attention to potentially end your life. You may have been right, but you're still dead, is my dad saying for this situation. Posting on social media that you're going on vacation. A high school friend of mine did that a couple of years ago. Multiple posts on Facebook announcing she and her husband were going to Bermuda for 2 weeks. They came home to a burgled house. Bank loans and credit cards. Just because you're approved doesn't mean you can afford it. Me, contemplating buying an axe this weekend so I can do some axe throwing in my backyard. Why? Because I can. Drunk calling your ex. Or your boss. Or my mom. Please stop, Derek. That device allowing an Amazon carrier to unlock and open the front door of your house to deliver packages. Either one of the self-professed genius tech brothers in Silicon Valley didn't think this through, or they're incredibly naive about how easily something like that could be abused. The dog walking company I work for uses this for when the owners aren't home. Not even a one-time code. It's the same code for every walker, unless the pet parents changes it. It's mind-boggling to me that so many people are super cool letting strangers with nice profiles into their homes. I could have taken stuff so many times. Never would, but sometimes I can't help but notice. On the flip side, in the back of my mind I worry that an owner could claim I damaged or stole something, and I get in trouble, since it'd be hard to prove I didn't. Name your kid idiotic names. Bullying is a big one. I tried to bully a person once, but they just laughed. Apparently I'm not a convincing bully. That's how I found out the bullying career is not for me. Competition was too tough at my school. In the end, I finished at victim side of things and required professional assistance of the teacher in order to enforce anti-bullying regulations. Eating the whole damn pint of ice cream. My lactose intolerance says no, but my everything else says yes. Hoard toilet paper. Yeah, tell that to all my neighbors who have so much freaking TP that they are arranging TP roll hunts in their yards and bragging about it all over Facebook. While I'm forced to go begging for TP from the one place in town that is selling it, Akara Restaurant. Link to Facebook post, i.inga.com link. Abuse your position slash power. People who want power are generally the people who should least have it. I don't want this job. Hire this man immediately. He's the perfect candidate. Most crafts on the internet. Just because my asshole can stretch to 8 inches and a raccoon can go through a 4-inch hole, does not mean I should shove 2 raccoons up my ass. How else am I supposed to get them past airport security? Personal anecdote, I was with friends, and we were just hanging around having pizza. I'm challenged to put a bunch of different sauces and toppings on a slice of cheese pizza, because I'll eat any weird food when challenged. The gauntlet included sriracha, horseradish, honey mustard, cottage cheese, and whipped cream. I downed it, and was sick for the rest of the night. No vomiting, but it was not fun. Never combine sriracha, whipped cream, and horseradish. Just because I usually have an iron stomach does not mean I should eat everything I'm challenged to eat. Cheating. Relationships or just in general? Mainly directed towards relationships, I suppose. Oh good, because I'm a cheating nightmare when I play Monopoly. This is kind of thing you need to remind Jake Paul every 5 seconds. No. Don't film corpses. Bad. Bad. Sit. Bad human. Very bad human. Now repeat after me, I will not be an asshole. I will not do stupid shit. I will not be a stupid shit. Now are you going to behave, or will I have to take away your ad revenue again? Truck nuts. Commenting on Reddit. Or commenting things like first. Or the no one. No one. Me, first. Edit, OMG thanks for the silver and loads of upvotes, thanks a lot. I mean, there's nothing physically stopping you from eating poop, but why would you? Your taste buds and nose physically stop you from doing it, but a twisted mind does not care. When I was like 2, I was taking a bath and my mom stepped out for a few seconds to answer the phone. She says she came back to me with turds floating around the bathtub. Apparently I was picking them up and eating them as they went by, like some sort of floating shit buffet. So I'm hoping there is an age contingency to this, otherwise I was a twisted little toddler. Please delete this. I've been trying for 30 years, trust me. Had more kids than able to handle, feed, clothe, spend time with, etc. Do home chemistry, TL, doctor of a long and stupid story, second degree burns on my face. Here's one from Southern California back during the bank crisis of 2008. An unhappy citizen scrawled some disparaging comments about the bank on the bank's sidewalk with chalk. The police took the report and the city attorney charged the guy with a felony. They offered the man a plea deal to that felony with no jail and 5 years supervised probation. The guy passed. There was absolutely no publicity until it went to court, where it went to a jury which found him not guilty. The press finally saw the absurdity of the whole case and made a fuss, since the city's tab was $300,000 back during the recession. The city attorney blamed it on a lack of communication with his underlings. When asked how the unkind words were eventually cleaned up, a bank employee testified he sprayed it with a hose and it all ran off to the gutter. I actually walked into the courtroom on this case for an unrelated matter and it was packed. Some details are wrong though. It was misdemeanors and the plea deal offered was a simple infraction with no fine, not felonies, and the bank claimed it hired a power washing company to remove it, which cost them a few grand. Latimes.com link. A few grand? To use a power washer? To get rid of some chalk? Sounds like they found a scapegoat to foot the bill for their power washed building. Cloning dinosaurs. That's actually a you should. Pulling out your phone and taking unsolicited videos / pictures of people in public places for the entertainment of the internet. Once had some girl take pictures of me, very obviously, then laugh to herself while I was having a panic attack on the train. It's definitely not a nice feeling. Disney making crap live action versions of classic animation. Imagine a live action Toy Story. I'd rather not. Just being quiet sometimes. My brother had passed away, I was out of country, so I had to return. In doing so, I went to a favorite restaurant that we both worked at as teenagers. Same hostess, most of the same coworkers even later. Upon leaving, one of the waitresses said, "Please tell your brother I said hi, he was so great." I just smiled at her and told her I would. Not to lie, but her comment was so innocent and she was at work. No reason to bring up a tragedy and in turn make her feel bad. Cannibalism. It's actually legal because no country in the world actually has a law against it. In fact, the laws were against you murdering someone, not eating them. If somebody slashed their own arm off with a sword and allowed you to eat it, you could. Should you, though? No. A lot of states in the US just turn it into a desecration of a corpse charge or other loopholes as a way to still lock the person up. But nope, no cannibalism laws. Edit. After reading all these replies, I think it's worth speculating why there isn't a law in place. My theory, which may be wrong, is that cannibalism is such an uncommon occurrence, and so many cases involve desperate illness and survival, that it's likely a gray area. Cannibalism, when done in a malicious way, usually has other crimes attached that can be addressed: murder, manslaughter, corpse desecration, etc. If there is truly no other possible crime to attach to the incident, it was most likely an innocent act for survival. That likely makes judging the occurrence in court much easier. Sticking your dick in a light socket. Wait, what? I tried it, it worked out pretty well. It was enlightening. Just because you can fight off 50 hamsters at once doesn't mean that you should. You're right. We should really have a round table and hear out the demands of the hamsters. Okay, now I want to have a Webex with 50 hamsters at once. Is someone chewing on something? Please go on mute. Angry hamster sounds. Okay, we'll get to that in a second. Who just joined? Apologetic hamster sounds. No problem. Shit in the shower. Exercise your freedom of speech in a library. Spend all your stimulus money on hentai. It's surprisingly easy to fit a light bulb in your mouth, but almost impossible to remove it without it shattering. Not vaccinating your kids. Play videos with high volume at public places. Edit. OMG, thank you guys for all the upvotes and awards. I'm new to Reddit and literally jumping RN. Or talk with someone on speaker. Unless you're arguing. I gotta hear both sides, so I know whose side I'm on. Making a cover of Hallelujah. Eating the entire packet of sugar cookies. It's a bad idea, trust me. Being a huge pose like ripping open a homeless man's tent, or stealing someone's dog then covering it in cement and glue. Instantly locks dogs inside house, and never lets them out without supervision again. Shooting video in portrait mode. Own tigers. Just because you can bombard kids with homework during quarantine, doesn't mean you should. Make things big text for no reason. Underage unprotected sex. I'm no prude, but it's one of those things that you just shouldn't do if you can't fully deal with the consequences yourself. If you can't drive yourself to the local pharmacy to get condoms, or to a center to get tested, if you don't want to disclose shit to your parents, you shouldn't be doing it. Not to ruin the fun, but STDs now are rampant and things like syphilis, which depending on the person, can have little to no symptoms, can kill unsuspecting people young and suddenly years later. The risk to benefit ratio isn't really in your odds, not to mention underage pregnancy. Getting pregnant underage isn't a crime and people shouldn't be bullied for it, but it can mess with your life, especially if you are in high school, and you got plenty of time to figure that stuff out later. Just something to think about. Face tattoos. The film Cats, 2019. Thanks for watching. Do you have something to share? Leave it in the comments. Please like and subscribe for more Reddit readings. Links mentioned in this video can be found in the description. Have a great day.